and gentlemen. Firstly, to present myself, I'm from the University of Economics and Finance, which is a private university based in Sofia, and also we implement the program of the University of Sheffield International Faculty. My topic for today is socio-economic implications for sustainable business. We are well aware that today's economy needs redefinitions in various aspects, and this is mainly to provide for sustainable development of business, to change the common practices of the industrial economy, and to further reinforce the effects of sustainability measures which are implemented in business operations. And you are well aware of what sustainability means. We trigger three main aspects of sustainability: social development, environmental preservation, and behind all of these, the main objective is to, of course, sustain and keep up good economic growth, that's economic development. So the objectives of the paper are to provide a comprehensive theoretical ground of sustainability measures, how they can be combined in order to achieve higher profitability levels of companies, to prove that sustainability measures are and should be cost neutral at least, and cost effective, and finally to they should bring competitive advantage to companies which operate in various fields of industry, and this also leads to the creation of value through minimizing expenses. Lastly, but very important is as well, these measures benefit workers, communities, and also indigenous cultures. We are well aware of what this means. All implications of sustainability measures are identified in the paper: cost saving, risk avoidance, improvement in business performance, and employee benefits. Now, the important pieces in the paper is that all of these four elements, four implications, should reinforce each other. They should work in synchrony, otherwise there is no permanent effect. There could be some temporary effect, but in order to achieve a long-term implication for the social and business environment, we should have a gradual and reinforcing importance of all of these elements. There are several studies which are provided in the paper, and we touch upon these studies which lead to specific outcomes. There are no significant costs to social and environmental performance after certain testing in industries. Investors who choose the environmental leaders are doing better than those who choose the environmental laggards. And also, equity portfolios with good environmental ratings are likely to perform better on the stock market. That is, that their shareholder value increases. How does the shareholder value lead to this? It's very important to note on the second part, risk avoidance for sustainability. And the thesis here is that environmental and social liabilities can reduce shareholder value, while vice versa, the systematic implementation of sustainability measures cuts costs and increases shareholder value. And there are three ways of reduction of shareholder value: through violation of environmental laws, through the lack of preparation of enterprises for environmental regulation implementation, and also shareholder value can decrease due to inadequate disclosure of environmental liabilities. And several cases are provided. One of the most prominent ones are those which have been identified in China for the last 3 years, multinational companies like Panasonic and Pepsi, and the way they have violated environmental laws through wastewater treatment, and also violation, and also through the violation of the requirement to provide environmental assessment of construction of operating premises. Employee benefits, how the employees could benefit through sustainability measures, basically through the improvement of living conditions and also income of workers in developing nations, and providing promising ways to cut operating costs and generate new industries and new jobs as an outcome of introduction of new products. And these new products, as an outcome of sustainability, are producing of biofuels such as ethanol, and also designed in buildings, operating wind power, electricity generators, manufacturing products from recycled byproducts, and waste from other processes, destruction of old buildings to reuse raw materials, which is closing the loop, so-called circular economy, and also designing and constructing green buildings. Finally, the last element which is touched upon in the analysis is the improvement in business performance, which is the required outcome. Organizations are complex systems, this is what we claim in the paper. And just like every other function of the human body is connected to each other, so it should be in the organizations. The system have to be specific, they should have specific purposes. All elements should reinforce each other, and they should be arranged in such a way to reinforce each other and be dependent. And also there should be sustainability feedback. What is important here is to note that when sustainability measures are implemented in organizations to improve business performance, they should reinforce each other, and these are the conclusions that are reached through the analysis in the paper. We start from cost reduction to increase sustainability and profitability of companies, risk avoidance with regards to capital management and shareholder value, improvement of employee and community benefits through the creation of new jobs in the industries, and gradually this leads to competitive advantage of companies to remain on the market for a long term, and we come up to increased profitability levels of business. So we close the loop. And with the reinforcement of each of these elements, the loop is closed further on to reach the highest step, which is increased profitability. Thank you for your attention.